Now, in last, we are discussing about that variant 1. In this lecture, we are consider variant 2 intermediate code representation. Now, for that purpose, when we consider the variant 1 intermediate code representation, we discuss about how to process the statement, how to process the operand 1, how to process the operand 2. Here, when we consider the operand 1, it is sometimes a register. Secondly, it is sometimes a particular condition code, less than equal to, greater than equal to. In according to the given operand value, we consider the corresponding opcode from the mnemonic table. Okay, and every operand can be represented here. That is type of operand. That is which type of operand class will be given there. The statement class. And secondly, we can consider the corresponding opcode to the given operand. Okay. Now, in case of the variant 2 representation, here declarative and assembler directives are processed in the same way of variant 1 in intermediate code. ज्या पद्धतीने variant 1 intermediate code represent केले होते किंवा व्हॅरियंट वन इंटरमिडिएट कोड्स त्यामध्ये रिप्रेझेंट केलेले होते. व्हॅरियंट वन मध्ये ज्या पद्धतीने डिक्लेरेटिव्ह स्टेटमेंट मेन्शन केले, डिक्लेरेटिव्ह स्टेटमेंट कन्सिडर द क्लास डी एल अँड करस्पॉन्डिंग व्हॅल्यू आयदर डी एस ऑर डी सी यूज. ओके, असेम्बलर डायरेक्टिव्ह कन्सिडर द ए डी एज अ क्लास अँड करस्पॉन्डिंग व्हॅल्यू गिवन फ्रॉम स्टार्ट एंड ओरिजिन, देन करस्पॉन्डिंग दॅट इज इक्यू ऑर लिटरल्स. ओके, according to that particular code will be assigned to that assembler directives. Here both statements are represented as per variant 1. It differs from variant 1 in that operand fields is selectively replaced in their processed form. The difference between variant 1 and variant 2, that is the major difference, is that the operand field, that is the operand field 1, now this operand field is represented or it placed as per their corresponding original form, okay, or in the form of processing. Here we can consider the imperative statements, that is operand 1, then register and condition code will be given to this operand 1. Okay, here we can consider operand 1 field as a register or it is given a condition code. Now it kept in as its source form, that is we can use register, that is a register. We don't replace the corresponding code. Okay, we set is as it is, that is source form, that is a register as it is a register. Okay, condition code le as it is le. We don't replace corresponding opcode in case of the variant 2. Okay, now in case of the operand 2, only literals and constants are processed. Literals and constants are processed in the sense we can represent literal as per literal class or the class for that particular literal as L and corresponding value from the literal table. That is the processing of that variant representation. Okay, only literals and constants can be processed. Okay, symbol does not require to process in case of the variant 2. फक्त processing कसे करायचे, constants आणि लिटरलचं प्रोसेसिंग करायचंय. सिम्बॉल जर असेल तर तो सिम्बॉल रिप्लेस करायचा नाही. प्रोसेसिंग करायचं म्हणजे काय करायचं, ऑपरेंड क्लास इज एल अँड कोड फील्ड कंटेन्स द ऑर्डिनल नंबर ऑफ अ लिटरल इन लिटरल टेबल, सो इट इज रिप्रेझेंटेड बाय अ पेअर एल हॅश, हॅश इन द सेन्स दॅट इज द लिटरल अवेलेबल इन टू दॅट लिटरल टेबल. सेकंडली, इफ ऑपरेंड टू इज अ कॉन्स्टंट, देन ऑपरेंड क्लास विल बी गिवन टू दॅट कॉन्स्टंट एज सी अँड फील्ड इज नथिंग बट इंटरनल रिप्रेझेंटेशन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टंट विच इज रिप्रेझेंटेड विथ सी हॅश. ओके, this is the only difference between variant 1 and variant 2. Now here we can consider the operand 2 is a symbol, then symbol is not processed during the pass 1, it is kept in the source form only. If you have the symbol, then it is set as it is, to process karaycha nahi. Apan variant 1 mode symbol pan process kela, literal process kele, ani second operand madhe constant pan tya paddhatine process kele, parantu variant 2 madhe tasa processing denyachi garaj nahi. Now we can see this particular example. We consider the variant 1 variant 2 representation here. Variant 2 representation, it is given variant 1, but actually it is the variant 2 representation. Okay, here start 200, it is the directives, that's why we consider AD01. because we can see here declarative statement and assembler directives, which are processed in the same way as variant 1. That's why we can consider start as a directive. We process according to the variant 1, AD01, which is the code for the start. And 200, it is the constant value. We consider the class for constant as C and internal representation as 200 as it is. Okay. Now, next thing is nothing but the declarative statement. We can consider declarative statement are also processed as the variant 1. DS, it is the declarative. Class is nothing but DL and 02, the corresponding number in the given symbol table. Okay. Then, DL, it is the code. DL for DS. DS is the code. Hai, to code ithe 02 hai. And DC is the code that is 01. Hai. Ite 1 jo hai. Now, here we can consider 1 as a constant. That way we process that particular constant like same. Variant 1. 5DC5. DC is the declarative, so DL class and 01 for the DC statement. Code DC is a 01. And if 5 ha constant ahe, then C to open process kela. It is 5 equal to 5 ha literal ala. Okay. We also process that literal as L, 1. 1 is nothing but the literal 5 is present at the first position, 1th position in the literal table. But we see this A register. Here, A register does not process in variant 2. Okay. In case of the variant 1, here we can put the value of A register, code value of A register. It's an imperative statement. I have IS01. Okay. Add instructions of code 01. But register does not process is kept as source form. Okay. Zar ha code variant 1 sa asta, tar ite ha A register replace kashani zala asta. 1 ni replace zala asta. Now we can represent that A register with 1. But in case of the variant 2, it is not process. Okay. In case of move R A register A, again here it imperative it is the imperative statement. That's why we consider class IS04 is the code for move R. A register kept as it is in the source form, and symbol A is also kept as in the symbol source form. It is also not process. Ha symbol ahe mhanun to process zalela nahi. Constant kiwa literal asta tar to ya paiki kay zala asta, eka paddhatine to represent zala asta. Again, next thing, BCLE, again, here it is an imperative statement. That's why BC has the opcode 07. We use this particular representation. B does not process our conditions. Okay, operand to one field ji ahe, fakta registers ani je condition code ahe. Register ani condition code as use karto, but they are not processed in operand one field. Okay, next thing is nothing but again, it is a symbol. It is also not processed again. And it is the directive, it is process AD02. We consider this difference between variant 1 and variant 2. Jar variant 1 code mi tumhala lihayla sangitla tar tumhi ha code as it is linear, ha as it is, he as it is rahil, he statement pan as it is rahil, itla statement pan as it is rahil, fakta ha statement madhe kay hoil, A register cha jo process form asel variant 1 madhe tacha code dila jail 1. Okay, tacha code kay dila jail tithe 1 dila jail. Tyanantar itla statement madhe काय वापरला जाणार, ए रजिस्टरचा कोड 1 वापरला जाईल आणि सिंबॉल ए, सिंबॉल ए चा क्लास असणारे एस आणि तो फर्स्ट लोकेशनला काय असेल त्या ठिकाणी टेबल मध्ये स्टोर झालेला असणार आहे. अशा पद्धतीचा कोड या ठिकाणी दिला जाईल. एलई चा कोड वापरला जाईल, अगेनचा सिंबॉल टेबलचा नंबर वापरला जाईल. ओके, दिस इज द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन व्हेरिएंट 1 कोड अँड व्हेरिएंट 2 कोड. लक्षात आले हा फरक आहे. नाउ वी नीड टू कंसीडर और टू सॉल्व सम एग्जांपल्स करस्पोंडिंग टू दैट वेरिएंट 1 एंड वेरिएंट 2. दैट इज वी नीड टू क्रिएट सम इंटरमीडिएट कोड रिप्रेजेंटेशन. ओके, वी डिस्कस दैट एग्जांपल्स आल्सो, वी कंसीडर दैट एग्जांपल्स आल्सो. नाउ बिफोर दैट वी कंसीडर द सम डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन दैट वेरिएंट 1 कोड एंड वेरिएंट 2 कोड. नाउ फर्स्ट वी कंसीडर द फैक्टर प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ द ऑपरेंड. ओके, इन केस ऑफ द वेरिएंट 1, ऑपरेंड 1, ऑपरेंड 2 बोथ आर कंप्लीटली प्रोसेस्ड. In case of the variant 2, operand 1 and operand 2 are not completely processed, because here some only we consider the literals and constants were processed. Other operand does not process. Operand 1 madhe compulsory apan ek register vaparto kiwa condition code vaparto. Okay, but in that case both are not processed in case of the variant 2. Where we consider the second difference is nothing but the compactness. Variant 1 is more compact, nearly equivalent to the target code. Okay. And in case of the variant 2, it is less compact as compared to the variant 1, because some statements, some symbols were not processed in variant 2. time is given that in case of pass 1 requires more time, pass 1 requires less time for variant 2. Work distribution of phases, passes, याचं वर्क डिस्ट्रीब्युशन कसं केलं जातं बघा. ड्यू टू व्हॅरियंट वन पास वन हॅज टू परफॉर्म मोर वर्क विच सिम्प्लिफाय द टास्क ऑफ पास टू. जास्तीत जास्त जे टास्क आहे पास वन मध्येच व्हॅरियंट वनच्या करस्पॉन्डिंग कम्प्लीट केले जातात, जेणेकरून पास टू हा काय केला जातो सिम्प्लिफाय होईल. नाउ इन केस ऑफ द व्हॅरियंट टू रिड्यूस द वर्क ऑफ पास वन. ओके, पास वनचं वर्क इथे रिड्यूस झालंय, बट ट्रान्सफरिंग द बर्डन ऑफ ऑपरेंड प्रोसेसिंग टू द पास टू बिकॉज सम आर नॉट प्रोसेस pass 2 requires to process them. Okay, now memory requirement will be considered here for that pass 1 and for variant 1 and variant 2. We can see this here, pass 1 occupy more memory than the pass 2, so memory requirement of both passes are unequal, so overall memory is not utilized properly as shown. Proper utilization ka jala nahi, because here we can consider the complete memory requirement of pass 1 here. This is the data structure and this is the work area. Both are similar to both passes. This is the pass 1 representation, this is the pass 2 representation. Memory requirement in pass 1, it is not completely required in case of the pass 2. Some memory will become free in case of the pass 2, those allocated in pass 1. This is not a proper arrangement of the memory. But in case of the variant 2, those memory allocated to pass 1, only such a memory or only that amount of memory will be used in pass 2 also. Okay, data structure and work area can be considered, and free space will be given on the same side of pass 1 and in variant 1 and variant 2. This is the common differences available according to the factor in a variant 1 and in a variant 2, according to the operand, processing of the operand, compactness, time, work distribution of passes and memory requirements. Okay, that is nothing but the some differences given in case of the variant 1 and variant 2. And last point will be given to that is nothing but the listing and error reporting. Okay, what is that listing and what is the error reporting? In this case, it is the important parameter in case of the assembler. Now when we write the particular program, we have some errors. It is possible some errors will be occurs in case of that particular program. Okay, error reporting is related to the speed and memory requirement of the assembler. Here we consider error indication is handled in differently in single and two pass assembler. Both type of assemblers, that is single pass assembler or two pass assembler, error handling mechanism is different. Why it is? Because when we consider the single pass assembler, all errors cannot be displayed immediately after erroneous statement is occurred. When we have the error statement, immediately that error will not display in case of the pass 1 because of the forward references. Okay, we discussed that forward references problem in previous also. That is, those variables are used first and declared later. That is nothing but the forward references. And some statement can have such a variables or such a symbols which has a forward references. Now that's why it is handled with the help of back patching methods. Now it is not a complete error. If our program is scanned completely, then and then error will be removed. That's why in single pass assembler the error are not display when they are occur in the given statement. Just statement la error ali tya statement varti ti display honar nahi, tyala he karan ahe because of the forward references. कारण ती एरर व्हेरिएबल डिक्लेरेशनच्या बाबतीत असू शकते, बरोबर. आणि ती एरर रिकवर केव्हा होते? जेव्हा तुमचा कंप्लीट प्रोग्राम स्कॅन होणार आहे, तुमचा प्रोग्राम एंडिंगला जाणार आहे, बॅक पॅचिंग मेथड इम्प्लिमेंट होणार आहे, त्यानंतर तो एरर रिमूव्ह होतोय. म्हणजे ती ऍक्च्युअली त्या ठिकाणची एरर नसणार आहे. दॅट्स वाय वी कन्सिडर दिस मेकॅनिझम इन केस ऑफ द सिंगल पास. नाउ सेकंड थिंग इज नथिंग बट सो इट इज प्रेफर्ड टू लिस्ट ऑल एरर्स ऍट द एंड ऑफ प्रोग्राम. सगळ्या एरर्स कुठे लिस्टिंग केलं जाईल त्यांचं, प्रोग्रामच्या एंडिंगला त्या शो केल्या जातील, than after each erroneous statement in the single pass. Okay, now in case of the pass 2 assembler, error listing is done at a time of pass 1. Okay, error are listed at the time of pass 1. In this case, some assembler prefers listing of errors against each erroneous statement. If a particular statement can have error, then it immediately can be displayed. ओके, ज्या स्टेटमेंटला एरर आली त्या स्टेटमेंटला ती एरर काय होते, डिस्प्ले केले जाते प्रत्येक एरर स्टेटमेंटला एरर काय होते त्या ठिकाणी शो होते बिकॉज फर्स्ट पास इज हँडल्ड फर्स्ट पास मध्ये त्याचे सिम्बॉल्स आयडेंटिफाय झालेले असतात सगळे डेटा स्ट्रक्चर क्रिएट झालेले असतात त्यामुळे मॅक्झिमम एरर्स ह्या फर्स्ट पासलाच काय केल्या जातात त्या ठिकाणी रिकव्हर केल्या जातात बाय डिलिंग अ प्रोग्राम लिस्टिंग अँड एरर रिपोर्टिंग टिल पास टू पहिल्या पास मध्ये सगळे एरर लिस्टिंग दिलं जाईल तरच पुढचा पास कंटिन्यू केला जातो किंवा पुढचा पास त्या ठिकाणी काय केला जातो इन केला जातो तोपर्यंत तो नेक्स्ट पास त्या ठिकाणी इन केला जात नाही किंवा सेकंड पास त्या ठिकाणी स्टार्ट केला जात नाही दीज आर नथिंग बट सम रिप्रेझेंटेशन ऑर दॅट इज नथिंग बट द रिप्रेझेंटेशन ऑफ एरर लिस्टिंग अँड रिपोर्टिंग नाउ नेक्स्ट थिंग इज इन दिस केस वी कन्सिडर सम असेंबलर विल प्रेफर द एरर लिस्टिंग इन ईच स्टेट ड्यूरिंग द पास टू Now, in this second type of method, errors are effectively reported, but source program is required in pass 2. जे जर आपण पास टू डिले करेपर्यंत एरर लिस्टिंग ज्या ठिकाणी आपण रिप्रेझेंट करतो जर आपण ते एरर लिस्टिंग कंटिन्यू करत गेलो प्रत्येक स्टेटमेंटला एरर लिस्टिंग जर त्या ठिकाणी मेन्शन करत गेलो तर सेकंड पास मध्ये आपल्याला इंटरमिडिएट कोड मिळालेला असतो आयसी कोड आलेला असतो आणि एरर लिस्टिंग जर प्रत्येक स्टेटमेंटला सेकंड पास मध्ये जर आपण एरर लिस्टिंग फाइंड आउट करायचं ठरवलं तर त्या ठिकाणी कशाची गरज पडणार आहे तुम्हाला तुमचा ओरिजिनल सोर्स प्रोग्राम जो आहे नाउ दॅट सोर्स कोड इज रिक्वायर्ड इन पास टू ऑल्सो ओके नाउ हिअर वन एक्झाम्पल इज गिव्हन देअर दॅट इज टू आयडेंटिफाय द एरर्स नाउ दॅट एरर्स आर गिव्हन पाठीमागे आपण एक प्रोग्राम घेतला होता बघा जिथे व्हेरिएबल आपण वापरला परंतु त्याचं डिक्लेरेशन दिलं नव्हतं ओके नाउ व्हेरिएबल ऑर सिम्बॉल ए विल बी डिक्लेअर्ड लॅटर बट इट इज यूज फर्स्ट नाउ द एरर विल बी गिव्हन दॅट जनरली तुम्ही तुमचा प्रोग्राम जेव्हा रन केला सीचा प्रोग्राम व्हेरिएबल डिक्लेअर न करता जर वापरला तर अनडिफाईन्ड सिम्बॉल बरोबर असा एरर तुम्हाला त्या ठिकाणी शो केला जातो आता मी जर समजा सबट्रॅक्ट अशी इन्स्ट्रक्शन वापरली सबट्रॅक्ट इट इज नॉट अ मेमोनिक गिव्हन इन युअर असेंब्ली ओके असेंब्ली लँग्वेज मध्ये सबट्रॅक्ट नावाचं सिम्बॉल नाहीये वी हॅव सब symbol name as a sub that's why it is undefined or invalid mnemonic error will be displayed okay now next thing is nothing but we consider mult a comma b register okay now in this case this is the wrong statement because first of all we consider the representation of register first operand always register or condition code and second operand is nothing but the symbol that's why it is the invalid or syntax error will be reported okay invalid literal when we give the literal value as equal to 5 only literal can be given in the form of single quote but we can use only value this like this we can representation in this way it is not a proper literal representation that's why we can consider invalid literal as a error okay now next one is nothing but we declare a particular variable twice okay suppose we consider a DC फर्स्ट टाइम तुम्ही ए डी सी ने डिक्लेअर केला वन आणि परत ए डिक्लेअर करताय ए डीएस ओके ए डीएस सपोज वन नाउ हिअर डुप्लिकेशन ऑफ दिस सिम्बॉल ए दॅट इज द डुप्लिकेट एरर विल बी जनरेटेड समटाइम्स वी कॅन हॅव वी यूज द सिम्बॉल ओके प्रोग्राम मध्ये तुम्ही ए हा सिम्बॉल वापरला परंतु तो डिक्लेअरच झाला नाही पुढेच डिक्लेअर केला नाही प्रोग्राम एंड पण झाला डिक्लेअरच झालेला नाही Now we can consider a symbol undefined symbol A or undefined symbol B. These are nothing but the error reporting and error listing in case of the pass 1 as well as we consider in case of the pass 2 also. These are the errors that is invalid literals, undefined symbol, invalid symbol or invalid mnemonic like this way. We consider all these representation in case of the particular representation or in case of that particular translation process of a assembly program into the machine program okay now you are we are consider all these things when we perform the translation of our assembly program into the machine program that is we consider all these things from start to end for the translation procedure how to perform the translation of that particular program okay